Hey guys, welcome back to Brand Knowledge, and it's a brand new playlist here. It's Business Jargons and Financial Literacy. I'll be right back after the intro. Hey guys, welcome back to Brand Knowledge. It's your boy Jaden Sapon. You know, over here we talk about business and branding just to help you level up in all your entrepreneurial endeavors. So today we're talking about two things: runway and scope creep. Okay, so what's a runway? Now, bringing it into the airline world, a runway is basically, you know, the road that is made for the plane. Before a plane takes off, it has to build some momentum before it takes off. So that road is called the runway, okay? So called the tarmac. And before it also lands, you know, it has to have enough room or space for it to, you know, land and then finally come to a halt. Okay, now let's take that and bring that into the business world. What is runway in the business world? Now, a runway in the business world is basically an amount of time that a company has before it runs out of cash. Now, cash is king. So for example, if your burn rate is 10,000 Ghana cedis every month, and what you have in the bank is 100,000 Ghana cedis, it means you have about 10 months, okay? 10 months to generate positive cash flow into your business. Else, on the 11th month, you will die. If you don't generate any cash flow into the business, 10 months, you will squander all the money. Because every month, you will need to pay employees, you need to pay bills, you need to sort too many things out, okay? And it will only sustain you for 10 months. That's it. On the 11th month, you are dead. So you need to be able to generate cash flow, positive cash flow into the business so that you can keep things going, okay? Okay, so what you should ask yourself is, if as a business, you don't get customers coming in, like no work for 6 months, 12 months straight, do you think your runway, like what's in the bank, will sustain your business? Ask yourself this question, because there's risk all around us. There's risk all around us. So that's why I always advise people to have a strict bookkeeping. Have a strict bookkeeping. Be strict. Don't squander money from your business for your personal things. No, the money is not yours. It's for the business. Okay. Okay. So let's jump onto the next one. Now, this is scope creep. So this is something that is popular amongst the project management space. If you're someone who handles projects often, you know about scope creep and you've heard about scope. You deal with scopes, okay? This is something that a lot of creatives deal with all the time, scope creep. There's always a creep in the scope that was set out by the customer. There is always a creep, always a creep. So what is scope creep? Now, scope creep refers to changes, continuous or basically uncontrolled growth in the project scope, okay, at any point in time after the project begins. So a lot can go wrong. So there are scenarios where deliverables have been given, the scope is set, the time period is set, okay, to achieve the project, and then the client comes in that let's throw in this, let's do this, let's do that, okay, with no new budget. And it's like you need to do the project with whatever new information has now come up, and that's going to mess a lot of things up. So that is what we mean by scope creep. So a lot can go wrong in scope creeping. So there are a lot of things that could go wrong with scope creep. Now, some of them are the team going down an unproductive or destructive path, wasting company resources, a weakening team communication, ruining chances of the project even being a success, okay? So all these things are as a byproduct of scope creep. So always avoid scope creep as a business, okay? Make sure to address, if scope creep pops up, request for a new budget for the project, okay? Now, there is a rising group of entrepreneurs out there who believe that all profit comes from risk. Okay? And so because of that, they charge risk on everything that they do. That way, if scope creep pops up, they just ignore it and execute. I want to be a part of that club, Charlie. Don't you think so? You should also be a part of the club. So let's do our best to join that club. Hey guys, so I hope this was informative. I hope you learned a thing or two about runway and scope creep. Now, always try to avoid the pitfalls that come with these two things, okay? So don't forget to hit the subscribe button as well as the bell button to be in sync with me every time I drop a new video. So hey, thank you guys for watching. God bless you guys, and I'll see you on the other side. Let's get it.